Good afternoon. Let's think about what comes to mind when you hear the words consumption and consumerism. And when people call you a consumer, we use these words every day, especially in an era in which we need to face up to new urgent responsibilities related, for example, to climate change. However, we often take the meaning of these words for granted, but in truth, consumption has a history and a very complex one. This is the focus of my fields of study, to analyze how consumption, the role of consumption in shaping the citizen's socio-political identity. Is the consumer the subject or rather the object of a specific political action? And what is the relationship between gender and consumption? These are just some of the questions that we, consumption historians, ask ourselves. My specific focus is on the relationship between austerity and consumption in Italy during the 70s. The end of the so-called golden age. The 70s were marked by two energy and economic crises. The first one took place in 1973 and led to a series of austerity policies, and by social and political turmoil, and thus represent a crucial decade in Italian history. It is in those years that environmental issues became of public concern, and in those years, Italian consumerism was born. However, despite its significance, this period is in part understudied by consumption historians. Thus, one of my aims is to help filling this gap. Specifically, I analyze, on the one hand, how a selection of prominent Italian enterprises, namely Eni, Fiat and Enel, reacted to the crisis and the challenges of the newly born consumer society. On the other, I explore how different cultural tendencies that constituted Italian society back then interpreted those changes and their own role within that social context. This is leading me to this end. I am currently investigating mass culture through magazines and advertisement, and what is emerging is that there was a really strong debate around topics such as austerity and consumption, and that's leading me to deconstruct some common but maybe not entirely right images that we have of the 70s. To conclude, the overall aim of my research is not only to deepen our knowledge of the 70s, but more importantly, to reconsider the struggle between austerity and consumption in modern Italy, thus shedding light on what consumption has meant and means. And that's important because understanding consumption and our role as consumers, and more importantly, as citizens, is the first step towards a new and more responsible global economy. Thank you.